Well, hello. Welcome to our concert tonight. This is the fourth concert, I think. We had a couple rained out a couple weeks in a row, so we're happy that the weather turned out so nice tonight. Our sponsor for this concert is the American Legion Auxiliary, Unit 67, and we thank them for their support. Chris, there's a lady that would like she would like a program, I think. Is it, put a mic in my hand and look out. I don't know. All right. We thank the Legion Auxiliary for their support and you for yours for being here tonight. Appreciate that. Tonight we're going to delve into three different types of music most of you are least aware of: jazz, blues, and rock. You may learn a little about the origins of these and what defines them, but mostly you're going to hear some music that you may know and hopefully that you'll enjoy. We're also going to welcome the Lake Mills High School Band Director, Don Gisha, tonight as a guest conductor on two pieces. But first, with an early jazz composition, Barnyard Blues. The Barnyard Blues is also known as the Livery Stable Blues. It was all about a copyright dispute, actually, around 1917. It's a New Orleans-style 12-bar blues. It starts with a 4-bar introduction, and then three distinct themes played in succession. The third theme consists of the trombone, oboe, and trumpet, imitating various barnyard animals. Sometimes we sound like barnyard animals while trying. Tonight, we're trying. So, the oboe is portraying a rooster, the trumpet a horse, and the trombone a cow, with the addition of some duck quacking going on in there as well. It's considered to be the first jazz recording when it was recorded by the original Dixieland Jazz Band, J-A-S-S was the way they spelled it then, on February 26, 1917. Here's the Barnyard Blues.
Thank you.
The blues can be traced back to songs the blacks sang while working as slaves in the fields. Jazz, which developed in part from blues and from ragtime, owes much of its development to African Americans as well. One of the key centers for the development of jazz was New Orleans. Tonight, we're going to spend some time at a New Orleans funeral. The piece starts with a somber processional led by the band to the cemetery to the strains of Just a Closer Walk with Thee. The mood changes after the graveside services, and the procession moves into an upbeat rendition of When the Saints Go Marching In. Here is At a Dixieland Jazz Funeral.
Thank you.
Thank you. Rock music developed in the late 40s and 50s and came in large part from jazz and swing. Tonight, we're going to share one of the early rock tunes that was made famous by Bobby Darin. Splish Splash is a 1958 novelty rock song performed and co-written by Bobby Darin. It was written by the famous DJ Murray the K with him, and he bet Darin, it came about because he bet Darin that he couldn't write a song that began with the words, "Splish Splash, I was taking a bath." Well, it was Darin's first hit, and the song helped to give him a major boost in his career. In a 1967 interview, Darin claimed that he was so happy about having his first hit that his skin condition cleared up. I don't think we can promise any improved skin conditions from listening to this, but we still think you're going to enjoy this. Splish Splash. Jazz and kind of bluesy sounds were not confined to bars and dance halls. In the 1920s, Paul Whiteman's band was working hard to, as Whiteman said, make a lady out of jazz. In a 1924 concert of modern American music at Aeolian Hall in New York, Whiteman introduced a new piece with the composer himself at the piano. George Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue has lived on as one of the best concert pieces of the 20th century. Tonight we're not going to be playing Rhapsody in Blue, but we are going to be playing another Gershwin tune that has some of that same bluesy feeling. It's one of three preludes originally written for piano by Gershwin. This is Gershwin's second prelude. Thank you. Right now, we'd like to invite Mitch Evelyn up to the stand. You can tell who that is with the guy with the big check. But we're very grateful for it.
On behalf of our generous customers at Lake Mills Market and our staff, we're very happy to be able to present this check for $9,714.81 through our Roundup program.
Considering how generous all of you and the market has been, we thought we would give Mitch something of high value, a City Band shirt.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mitch. And I think that's a fair trade, that check for the shirt. What I didn't mention, Mitch, is practice is Monday night. You've got the shirt now, so. Seeing that check kind of got me all
Twitter
confused.
Twitter paid. Yeah.
Twitter paid?
Twitter paid.
Okay. Vocabulary night. Well, I can't say this next piece is jazz, swing, or rock, but what I can say is I can't see having a concert without at least one or two marches. So here is one written by Henry Fillmore under the pseudonym of Harold Bennett and arranged by the late Nick Contorno. Dr. Contorno had been the director of the 1st Brigade Civil War Band for 12 years and director of music programs, band, and orchestra at Marquette University for 24 years. And who better than a school band director to conduct this piece composed by a pioneer of the school band movement? We're welcoming Dominic Gisha tonight. He'll be starting his 5th year as the Lake Mills High School band director, and he's here tonight to guest conduct on Courage March.
I told Dave that I would talk for a second and I wouldn't say anything bad about him, but I first wanted to thank the City Band for asking me to play or to conduct. It's my once a year kind of thing that I like to do with them, and I wanted to thank Dave and everybody here for supporting music in Lake Mills. We have a really awesome community that values the importance of music both here in the park and at our schools, and it's because of everybody here, so thank you for continuing to support music in our schools and our community. I just wave the stick, you guys follow me. We'll see if we end at the same time. We're gonna go quick.
Thank you.
I'll be back in a little bit.
We're good.
Thank you, Don. And he did such a good job, he's coming back. You're good. Back to our theme now. A movie that fanned interest in the blues and swing music in the early 1980s was The Blues Brothers. Tonight, we're going to play a medley of four songs from that movie. I Can't Turn You Loose, Soul Man, Soul Finger, and Everybody Needs Somebody to Love. Here's The Blues Brothers Review.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to move into the swing era now, featuring our saxophone section.
Figuring out whether I'm doing this right or not.
One of the most recognizable tunes from the swing era is a piece written by Joe Garland and made a hit by the Glenn Miller Band. Tonight we're going to feature our sax section playing In the Mood. On alto sax, we have Stacy Bargan, Nancy Lang, and Caitlin Peterson. On tenor sax, we have Anthony Klotz. And tonight, they're going to play one of the signature songs associated with the Glenn Miller Band and the swing era, In the Mood. Our performance of this piece tonight is dedicated to the memory of Dale Armantrout, who passed away in May. Dale played alto saxophone in the band and for several years served as the band's director. We thought this would be a very appropriate piece to honor her memory. And to conduct this piece, we're bringing back Dom Gysha to the podium once more.
Was there another one up there?
No.
All right, Jackson, you ready? She'll be fine. I hope. We'll keep playing if you guys smile. At one point.
Awards scholarships to graduating seniors.
There you go.
Okay, how's that?
That's
sorry. Each year, the city band awards scholarships to graduating seniors. On one hand, we're glad to be able to do it. On the other hand, we hate to do it because then we know they are heading elsewhere. However, we always hope, and they always know, that they are welcome back. So this year, it's interesting. I was looking at scholarships over the years, and it seems like we tend to go in groupings. So for example, 1 year, 2 years ago, went to a bunch of saxophones. Previous years, there were a few clarinetists. This year, we have brass players who will be awarded the scholarships this year. So we have two of them. I'll go in order of, I'll call it seniority, who's been in the band the longest. The first one is going to Bastian Wolf. Bastian's been playing with us since he was about six years. And as I hate to embarrass him, but Bastian started out about this tall with the band, and his voice was like this. And he's changed a lot. Bastian also recruited his sister, so we know there'll be a wolf in the band for at least a while. So anyway, Bastian is going to be going to St. Mary's in Winona. And after that, hopes to go on to the priesthood. And I thought, well, you know, Bastian, it's great to know you're going to be a priest, hopefully, but don't plan on me going to confession. So anyway, Bastian, it's our pleasure for the band to give you this scholarship. Best wishes to you. And as I said, we have two brass players. So we had a trombonist, and next we also have a trumpet player. Our trumpet player is Logan Wheat. And Logan's been with us for 3 years. And over the 3 years has progressively gotten better. We like to think we contributed to that, the fact that he was playing taps for Memorial Day for the high school band, and that he may have had a little piece or a little say in that. But Logan's also been great at recruiting others. So he is one of those star recruiter awards. But anyway, Bastian's going to be going to UW Rock County, where he
Logan.
I'm sorry. You know, it's all of these brass players. Logan is going to be going to UW Rock County and hopes to be a web designer. So who knows, maybe one of these years the city band will actually have a website. So anyway, we don't have to have too many expectations for you, Logan. But anyway, thanks a lot, Logan, and congratulations.
Tell those dogs down front we're fans of these young men too, so that's great.
Although not really swing or rock, the music of Leroy Anderson has been quite popular for about the last 80 years. Anderson recognized his music was concert music, but with a pop quality. He wrote and arranged for Arthur Fiedler and the Boston Pops, and the humor in his pieces is often evident. Tonight we're going to play one of those that where it is pretty evident. It's like jazz, it relies heavily on syncopation, so much so that it's called the Syncopated Clock.
Thank you.
Last month, we featured the tuba section in a very familiar tune from a not-so-familiar musical, No No Nanette. Although not technically swing, since it was introduced prior to the swing era, it does have a swing feel to it. And here again are Carl Keppel, Ian Saylor, and Kelsey Perry in T for Two for Tubas. '60s rock music scene was a group of four boys from Liverpool, England. From their appearance on the Ed Sullivan Show in 1964 to their breakup in 1969, my senior year, and actually many years beyond that, the Beatles have been a significant force in rock music. Tonight, we bring you a medley of three popular Beatles tunes, Ticket to Ride, Hey Jude, and Get Back. Here is the best of the Beatles. We've almost reached the end of another concert, and you're probably wondering, what? No audience participation? Don't worry. We're going to give you another shot at one from last month. Super Hit Mega Mix is a medley of four pretty recognizable tunes from... Oh, my watch thought I fell. I usually take that off. Super Hit Megamix is a medley of four pretty recognizable tunes from the 70s and the 90s. Get ready for this, Rock and Roll Part 2, or better known as the Hay Song. Whoop, there it is, by Tag Team, and YMCA by the Village People. Your work is primarily at the whoop, there it is moment, and the Saxons are going to help you again, like they did last month, and forming the YMCA when we get to it. Y-M...
Are you sure?
See to the left.
Before the last concert, I did it wrong for several weeks and nobody told me. And I'll probably do it wrong again. Anyway, I've been practicing. I hope to do better this time around, but who knows. Here it is, Super Hit Mega Mix.
Thank you.
There it is.
Thank you.
Catch my breath.
All right. I'd like to thank Don Bishop for joining us tonight. I want to say I really appreciate, we all really appreciate the very positive working relationship that we have with him, and we're grateful that he took a break from changing your son Henry's diapers to be with us here tonight.
So. Anything for you, Dave.
And thanks to Mitch.
And thank you, Mitch, for the gift from the market. We really appreciate that. I know the shirt isn't a fair trade, but you know, you're still welcome to come to Monday's rehearsal. Thank you very much for that. That's great. And I want to thank our sponsor, the American Legion Auxiliary, as well as all our sponsors this year. But most of all, thank you for being here, because it certainly is a lot more fun to play to people than to play to an empty park, I can tell you. So thank you for being here. Our next concert will be on August 4th at 7 p.m. We'll be right here. We're going to be having a joint concert with the Palmyra Eagle Community Band. So you have to get your seats early. I mean, they come over here and they'll stake out. They'll probably put tarps up and things to stake out their area. You know. But we hope to see you there. So now, if you're able, please rise and join us in the singing of our national anthem.